Hello everyone, I'm Kibitz, and welcome back to the Dyson Sphere program. Where last time we wildly expanded our production capacity and automated some pretty complex things like drones and logistics towers and even these spicy boys, which take the power from our new fusion power plant and charge batteries. And those charged batteries we send to Kappa Delphini 1, where all the batteries discharge to power what will be our first Forge World. And here we shall do everything necessary to turn that sun into a Dyson Sphere. And that is our goal to date, to actually start on our Dyson Sphere program here, automate some of the parts that we can, and completely industrialize this planet. And while I do that, you guys can industrialize that like button by smashing it into a fine powder. And with the Dyson Sphere, we actually have a lot unlocked. So in order to make it, we need to send solar sails into orbit with these rail ejectors. Then we receive the power from the sails with these ray receivers. And the sails, they're pretty straightforward. So over here, you can just see that they take graphene and weird looking popsicle. Oh, which is actually a photon combiner, of course, how could I mess that up? And this just takes some triangles and a circuit board. The triangles just take glass, the glass just takes rocks. So pretty much this is rocks, iron, and copper. Then the other thing we need is some graphene, which is just sulfuric acid and graphite, which is plentiful on the main world. Well, scratch that, it should be plentiful, but we have to drastically upgrade our oil setup here. Everything just keeps getting backed up, and we keep running into problems. We can't burn it fast enough. So we are going to figure out a solution for that. We're going to expand on this system as well, probably make another sulfuric acid setup, and then pretty much copy exactly what we did here, but with one fundamental twist. Well, technically two fundamental twists, because now we have the oil things here and then all of the chemical plants off to the right, so it's not just a straight line. You see, it's a literal twist, but there's an actual twist that's way more important. So the problem here, again, is that everything doesn't burn fast enough. So what we need to do to ensure that this system keeps running is to send everything to what shall now be dubbed the Great Dumpster Fire. So all the items will mainly be filtered through the bottom here, and that enters the system. But everything from the top, and this is probably like hydrogen or something, will go to that dumpster fire. This dumpster fire needs to be huge. It needs to have storage out the wazoo, and it needs to last forever. So all of this space here is going to become this great dumpster fire. It will have no special purpose except to literally burn everything. So we're gonna have two huge rows to burn all of the hydrogen. One row to burn the deuterium, another two rows to burn all of the refined fuel, and then finally, one more row for the carbon stuff. But yeah, general idea is we will just continue this going as far as it needs to go. We will have every thermal power station necessary to burn the world. It is going to be the finest dumpster fire, aside from the literal sun. Oh, it is beautiful, everyone. It is straight up gorgeous. The greatest dumpster fire ever conceived. I don't even know how many thermal generators are here, but my goodness, if this gets overloaded by the amount of oil and hydrogen we're making, I don't even know what to do anymore. This is nuts. This is at least 100, 200, I have no idea. And even if this does back up, we have some storage here as well. So again, the refined oil goes in here, little bit of hydrogen in there, deuterium, we're burning it too. And then the energetic coal stuff will go into here. I just have to belt it over from the other system though. Well, that's the plan. So let's just get this thing going. I brought a logistics tower to feed this, a bunch of oil from everywhere left in the planet. And this baby is running. And this should be set to filter into the system, good. As is the hydrogen. The hydrogen's not going into this system. The acid only takes the oil and a few other things.
But Mr. Kibbs, what about the hydrogen? You're making so much hydrogen. Isn't that like literally always the problem?
You're right, little Timmy. That is always the problem. So I made a big solution. A huge solution. A super massive solution. Probably a little overkill of a solution. The ultimate deuterium fabrication land area. Oh yeah. I went quite overkill with this. But I don't care. I don't want to have to worry about hydrogen ever again. So these fractionators take the hydrogen and they have like a very small chance to turn it into deuterium. Then the deuterium, we can use that for power, or what I'm using for, is just for burning. It's just another use for all the hydrogen. It gets it out of the way. And everyone in the comments tells me, oh Kibbs, you're gonna love having deuterium in the future. So now we have that solution already made. And most of the burners aren't even in use yet. So we're good there too. Though, you know what's another really good idea? Not burning literally all of this. Should probably split it up a little bit. And then just have the excess deuterium burn and the rest of it go into our power plant. Maybe we run out of deuterium there. It could happen. Maybe in like 1,000 years or something. But again, it could happen. But main thing being our spicy lemonade is complete and we can make all the graphene we need for the sails later on. However, we're gonna put a quick pin in that because I have learned something of critical importance. Are you ready for this? This is gonna blow your mind. But when you go from the planet view, check this out. You can go over to here, for example, click on one of these towers and take the item out of the tower. Wow. Yeah, that's pretty big news. Why is that big news? It's portable inventory around the entire planet. Meaning, if we just put our belts and stuff into towers like that, we'd never have to fly around to bins for the rest of time. So that is what I wanna do immediately. I wanna make some kind of like item storage hub. So all of our belts that we have over here, our machines, everything goes to one central hub and we're in like the super dreamland. And the hub is gonna be right beside our main factory, right in this little pizza slice. I've already kind of got it started too, because we needed a kabillion of these fractionator things. I brought some items over here to craft them. But then I was like, wait, why would I do that? Why don't I just bring all items here and craft somewhere else? And this can become our hub. See, much better idea. And now we'll just start to spam this area up with all of these towers. So we'll have a tower here maybe for all of our belts that this will request. We'll have another one for our sorters. And you kind of get the deal. It's just that we have to add in a ton of these logistics towers over here to fetch all the items, and then, oh bud, this area is gonna turn into the greatest spaghetti. Oh no, wait, there's gonna be even more spaghetti. Aside from the belts, we should get the machines. So over here we have like our logistics bots, we're gonna need a million of them. We have our logistics towers. Oh man, yep. We're gonna add even more logistics towers over here. They're gonna be everywhere. We're gonna cover the entire planet in them. Oh, it's gonna be fun, guys. Fun if you really like spaghetti. Hey, you know what? It could have been worse spaghetti. This is actually pretty good. So we got all the belts, all the sorters, all the jazz, even all the stuff over here, all cleaned up, organized, and sent off to towers so that now we have a proper logistics hub. So all the items we constantly use are all being brought in here. I even did a little bit of extra automating of all of the basics that we had before. And I did that all over at our starter base. I ripped the whole system out and rebuilt it from scratch. So everything starts down the production line, so we end up with just a bunch of items. And then with these few items, we can craft almost all of the beginner stuff in the game. So labs, the burners, and even the storage tanks and stuff. So all of our starter stuff, all of the basic machines that we need for automating are automated themselves now. Even the chemical plants, even all the oil stuff, everything, brother. And it's all brought into these towers to be sent off. And I have to admit, this is a very cool design. If you're making your own starter base, I'd highly recommend copying it. But you have three lines on one side and then three lines on the other side. I have, what is this? Stone, glass, circuit boards, then iron, these magnetic rings, and then the electric motors on the other side. And then these machines in the middle just grab from each side whatever they need, and off they go.
from here, because you have just enough space to go up a tile and scoot over those lines. So yeah, super, super good setup, and I've been loving it. I still need more iron though, but that's a problem for later. Actually, no, that's a problem for now. With all of this stuff automated and an entire equipment hub at our disposal, it's time to start conquering other worlds. And so we're going back to Kappa Delphini 1, and we're gonna automate everything. All of the resources that are strewn about, all of them are going to be harvested, processed, and sent into towers. We will conquer this world, and then we will start on our greatest factory yet, making the Dyson Sphere components! Oh yes. But this is gonna take like 90 quadrillion years. It's an entire planet. We have to set up like 100 of the smelters. So, I think I'll just boop it. Oh yeah, I wasn't kidding. It was literally hundreds of smelters. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. But I'd say the majority of the planet, 80% of it, is now all processed and ready to go. All the items are going into these towers to be sent wherever they need to be. And it's good. It's finally good. Oh my gosh. This stuff is repetitive. But done. So now we can start on our main actual project. Our Dyson Sphere factory. And I've prepped a little area just for it. Right over here. This shall be the eye of our Death Star. We will surround this area in hundreds of cannons, make thousands of machines to make all the sails and stuff. And it will all be centered around this so that every morning when the sun rises on this part of the planet, all of the cannons will start shooting, blah, 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 blah. And it will be awesome. So that's the plan. I have automated the rail ejectors, so we have a quadrillion of them, and oh, wow. They're some hefty lads. Okay. Didn't exactly expect that. But we're just gonna start placing all these down.
An EM rail ejector.
Oh.
You have taken the first step to build the Dyson Sphere.
Yes, I am quite aware. Cannon shoots sail by sun, scoop up power, and we're very happy. Wow, these things are big though. Can't really place them close together either, but that's okay. We have a whole plant to cover in these, and this is only the beginning. We might have to double this. Yeah, we're gonna be going pretty crazy with this factory here. So next order of business is actually building all of these sails. And again, all we need for the sails is the spicy ice cream and the graphene. And I finished off the graphene back on the homeworld because all it needed was just a little bit of coal. And over here, we're gonna focus on the ice cream, the photon combiner, which just needs stone and circuit boards, and the circuit boards are just the iron and copper. And guess what? We literally just gathered up an entire planet's worth of iron and copper, so that won't be a big problem. The problem will be how exactly we do it. Because we are going to go on an epic scale with this project. A truly epic scale. So I have built a very different system than all the rest of our factories in the world. And we are going to be relying on interplanetary ships for this one. So we have four big groupings for the sails. Then we're gonna have four big groupings for these photon things. Here, 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 and here. And then we have interplanetary logistics towers that will bring in all of the items. So with this, we're gonna request graphene. We're gonna request the circuit boards and the prisms. And by doing that, we'll get all the items we need for this system from anywhere we want. So I'll probably automate like the circuit boards on this world since we already have all the resources. But then when this world runs out of resources, this is an interplanetary tower, and we can just request stuff from elsewhere. And that's kind of like the big play. So yeah, the graphene's right there. It would scoot on by, go into this system, GGEZ. Then the circuit boards and the prisms will scoot out this way and into one of these little setups. I think the timing's okay on this as well. I haven't really done a lot of math in this game. I suppose it would have been important here, but what are you gonna do? It's one prism and one graphene, and in 4 seconds it makes 2 sails, okay? We're making 2 of these things every 3 seconds, so we're good there, I think. And then this is 2 prisms and 1 circuit board every 3 seconds. Okay, yeah, things should be fine. Things should be fine. I want there to be a lot of extra capacity here. Like, this stuff gotta overflow out the wazoo, because then later we can upgrade things. But for now, this whole system is in Mark II, and all of the solar sails are going to park here and over on the other side there, just while we figure things out. So the circuit boards and prisms have been automated on world, sent into the logistics towers, and now our beautiful little bots are flying over the sky, over to the core of our Death Star. And after letting the items kind of flow through for a bit, everything's working well, everything's lining up, and we're ready to start on the sails. So, just have to hook these final lines together, and the whole system is activated. Oh, bud. Oh, bud. That is so cool looking. Kind of looks strange. So many freaking machines, man. So many freaking machines. It's like a weird pulse almost. But I vibe with that. Of course, everything's completely filled up here because we had so much backup over in this area, so that's fine for now. Can't really measure rates, except we can see how this is looking. All right, these stack in 200 and we already have 500. Nice. So this is working very, very fast. It looks like it could do with an upgrade, but yeah, again, we'll deal with that later. Ah, the first section of our factory is complete. Oh yes, and I paved over the other area now too. So you can see the full grand design. Because later on, we're gonna have to make these Dyson Sphere components, and we'll be making those on the right side here. So it's like a giant eye kind of thing. Yeah, I vibe with this. Super vibe with this. Now to make our Dyson Sphere. Let's grab a couple of you bad boys. Boom. A little bit of power and see what the heck we do. So I have no, too close? Fine. So yeah, I have no idea exactly how this works. Clearly you just throw the solar sail in here and it joins the Dyson Swarm. Awesome. Oh, but wait, we need the ray receiver. Bruh, I didn't even unlock that yet. Whoops. Okay, let me get a couple of them first. Okay, there we go. Just went quickly back to our world, grabbed a couple of these guys, and they look pretty snazzy. Oh, they have like little eyes on the top of them. Dude, that's extremely creepy. Alrighty, photon generation, no idea what that means. Power generation, yes. Continues receiving max output, 5 megawatts? Are we gonna have to make a whole planet covered in these? Probably. Of course we are. Okay, well at least we can actually get the power now. So let's just throw our sails into the machine here. And this can only hold 20, brother. Then half a box. And now what on earth do we do? Edit orbit? What is this? Oh my gosh, what is going on? Hello? Show all orbits, add an orbit. Whoa! It's like freaking Halo, brother. What? Too close to a planet's orbit? Bruh, that'd be so neat. Imagine we fire the solar sails out here and they crash into a planet. Dude, that'd be awesome. Okay, though. Small, big. I guess if you wanted like a custom design, off you go. But we're not gonna be messing around with that all too much. And then the Dyson shell. I don't think we can get started on this yet. Yeah, no. We need like other tech stuff. We're just starting with the swarm. So we have this, that's fine. Let's then send it to, okay, that orbit. And it is sundown, so it cannot fire into the orbit. Perfect. Let's just wait a moment then. And then the first of our many cannons will activate. All right, cannons turning around. Here comes the sun. Ready yourself.
The end is now! Fire!
Fire, 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 fire! Destroy the sun! Do it!
Do it! Do it!
Why aren't you firing? Target yaw? What is going on? The sun's right there. How do you... What? What? It's not even aiming towards the sun. Hello? That's... What? The sun's up there. Friend, is this broken? Set the orbit. It's following. Brother, you're missing precious daylight. Did I screw something up? What is it trying to... Oh, no.
Oh, no, we're going, brother.
Oh, it doesn't make a sound effect. Sad.
But it's going. Oh, that's so neat. That animation's awesome.
Where is it firing?
Oh, those are the freaking things right there.
Oh, it's firing into the orbit that we set, not into the sun.
Oh, dude, that's wild then. You can see them just appear.
Oh, yeah, bud. And can we see it from out here? Yep. Look at that. Look at that. Our first couple little sails. They're so cute. Sadly, they're only gonna live for a couple minutes and then they burn up or something happens to them. But man, it's the start, the very beginning to the disaster that this planet will cause. Oh yes, it shall be glorious. And once we double up all the cannons here and actually get them activated, this is gonna look so freaking cool. I actually can't wait. However though, that's gonna be all for today. I just wanted to get this up and running so we can see what's going on. And next time we will continue with our Death Star project. So I hope you all enjoyed and thank you for watching, but have a fantastic rest of your day and bye-bye.